That wasn't me on the video earlier. I just had to say something. And ladies and gentlemen, have you had a good time so far? Well, you know, the really neat thing about being with the ensemble now and as a leader, I know last time we had a bit of a social event with some alumni members, and one of the alumni members, Kyle Fear, said to me, "So, how does it feel to be the director now?" And I said, "I don't have any feeling anymore." No, I'm just kidding. It's been a truly humbling experience, and I think for 32 years, my dad is above and beyond, not only being what I do as the world's best dad, number one dad, but in addition to that, also giving him a lot of extra additional time beyond his day job and all the volunteer stuff he's done. And to think this is now kicking on to 35 years, you would have heard some music from the beginning of the 50s. You would have heard music from the 60s. You would have heard an army of the classic shtick of different nationalities that only know about Ukulele. But now I'm going to go to the other shtick that he always used to use. And yes, I just said shtick. Okay, I just want to be clear with that. Because like in the 80s, continue this new generational thing, in the 80s, what time period, ladies and gentlemen? I said, what?
80s.
Okay, you are awake. In the 80s, if artists had only used ukulele to perform their music, like I'm talking Michael Jackson here, I'm talking Bon Jovi, I'm talking like the band Survivor. If you don't know who that is, it's okay. Or even like, well, who's that other one we sang? Whitney Houston, old age, I'm forgetting already. But yeah, if those artists and Pink, not Pink Floyd, but what's the other one? Guns N' Roses. If all those artists had only known about the ukulele, then we believe their music in the 80s would have sounded something
like this.
But a little louder, please. Something
like this.
That's the big ukulele.